Hitman Absolution is our most ambitious game here at IO Interactive. And to live up to the expectations that we had for this game, we had to create an entire new engine called Glacier 2. This gives us the capability to give an AI that's much more complex and a gameplay that is much more rewarding. We have really concentrated on expanding the arsenal of Agent 47 and trying to give the player as much choice as possible. But it's really your choice and to pick and choose all the tools that are at your disposal to give you a real variation and challenge out of a gameplay. The story of Hitman Absolution takes place after the events of Blood Money. The premise of the game is Agent 47 taking on the hardest contract of his life. He has to kill his former handler, Diana Burnwood. In the previous games, she has been telling Agent 47 what to do and giving him missions, while this, for the first time, he's on his own and he has to make up his choices. And this is what sends him on a personal journey and propels him through the story. In Hitman Absolution, we are introducing lots of new mechanics to Agent 47. We really wanted to expand on his arsenal and the tool that he has at his disposal. And we also want the player to be able to utilize them however way they want, in whatever situations they want. Mechanically wise, we are introducing one particular feature that is very central to Absolution. That is the instinct feature. It's an umbrella feature that covers several new abilities in 47's repertoire. One of them is just the plain instinct that allows him to see through walls and have a predicted path of enemy patrols. Also, he can gain information of the environment, for instance, the placement of hiding plain sight objects. Then he can go deeper into the instinct features, trying to take blend-in modes where if he's wearing a disguise from one of the guards on a level, he can try to fool them and blend into their ranks. And if hiding plain sight objects are present, he can also go to them and just be there among, surrounded by enemies. When the player hears the other character's thoughts on the level, it's when Agent 47 is doing his blend-in act. This can take only place if he's wearing a disguise and he is being looked at by a person wearing the similar outfit. If he has enough instinct, he can instinct in his instinct meter, he can basically start burning it, and Agent 47 will play an act to fool the character on screen.
I know you! You're Foster, right?
All the iconic elements from the previous installments, they are also doing a comeback in Absolution. You will, of course, experience the Silver Ballers, and you will see the Fiber Wire coming back. We hinted at it in the E3 demo, where instead of using the classic Fiber Wire, 47 picks up a power cord from a lamp to do exactly the same feature, but they're all coming back. And the suit, of course, comes back. That's a given. The liberty we take with 47 is not with his classic present attire, but with all the other disguises that he can pick up during the game. I know that some players are motivated by story, some players are motivated by the gameplay, but I personally like being a tourist in the games and just discover what is hidden in the small nooks and crannies and see what's always around the next corner. We really wanted to make this game feel as cinematic as possible, and to do that, we have tried to give all the characters on screen a life and a story. And this is a life and a story that you can get out by different approaches. Either you can be very voyeuristic and just look at the world and stay hidden in the shadows, but sometimes you have to be more direct and have a more violent approach to get something out of the world. And this variation is what I really personally like about this game, because the main cast is really good, but what sells it for me is all the other people in the game, all the bystanders that all have a small story to tell you. This is Hitman Absolution, and it's expected to come in 2012 for the PS3, the Xbox 360, and the PC.